Okay. Hello, dear friends, and loving greetings to all. It is my great pleasure to welcome you on this online course of SSE Education in Human Values. Today, we will continue with group activities. I am Vassiliki Stephanides. I live in Athens, Greece, and I will be your facilitator today. Now, in view of the tragic situation of the Ukrainian people, I would like to kindly ask the director of the Institute of SSE Education of South Europe, George Bebedelis, to speak to us.
Dear participants, dear friends, dear brothers and sisters in love, good morning. We are happy to be again together. As an institute and on behalf of our coordinating team, we thought that at these difficult moments that we all face, sharing the pain and the suffering that is happening in Ukraine, to say a few words. This, of course, as it happens with all of you and with all of the world, creates sorrow in our soul, because as an institute, we stand for the universal human values of love, truth, righteousness, peace, and nonviolence. And this situation, where we see and witness deaths, suffering of helpless old men and women, innocent children, brings a lot of sorrow in our hearts. What we can do in these critical moments? Let us unite our thoughts, words, and deeds together with our prayers and make our values firmer in our hearts and louder in our actions. Let us continue to nurture these ideals, knowing that they are inherent in all human beings and are indestructible and eternal. Let us envision peace now and make a pledge to stop any act of violence or conflict that spreads pain, suffering, and death. May reason prevail, love of neighbor, reconciliation, and solidarity, the gift of life. It is our deepest hope that core values such as coexistence, freedom, and justice, which the international community has established at the cost of so many sacrifices in the past, will be upheld and sustained. We trust that the love of God can transform us into one united family that will resist any kind of pain in the whole world and bring healing to the wounds of all those who are suffering at this very moment. Let us continue our prayers as we have communicated to you, as we discussed during the last session, and as we will keep doing, to continue our prayers for peace and happiness for the whole world. Let us keep in mind this universal prayer that we will all sing together in a while. Samasta loka sukhino bhavantu. This is an ancient Vedic prayer, which means, may all the worlds be happy. That means not only the world of humans, the world of animals, the world of plants, animate and inanimate worlds. May all the worlds be happy. Let's extend the light and love from our heart. And it is sure that the light is much stronger than darkness. And this is the only way to get away any pain, suffering, and darkness, by bringing light, love, and the human values of love, truth, righteousness, peace, and non-violence. We will continue our courses and the sessions according to the program as all these years, because this is the only way to bring in transformation first to ourselves and then to the whole planet. Thank you, and indeed from the bottom of my heart, and representing the whole team that works for this course, we pray and hope, and we are sure, I can say, that very soon this havoc will end. Vassiliki, please.
Thank you, George. Now I would like to invite Brigitte Castan, a member of our coordinating team, who has presented the silent sitting in January, to please give us a few words.
Thank you, dear Vassiliki. Indeed, thank you to George for your wise words, and just a few more words in that sense, to remind all of us what we have said on the session on the importance of meditation, silent sitting, and meditation on light for that purpose. Just to summarize very shortly what was said, it is stressing our individual responsibility as citizens of this world, that if we raise our vibration by spiritual practice, by meditation and other spiritual practices, also prayer, then we raise this vibration in ourselves, we fill ourselves with light, and then the light is spread to our family, our surrounding, society, community, and the whole world. And as George said and reminded us all, prayer is very important. We know that, as we said then, that monks in a monastery in Tibet or wherever in the world, in Christian monasteries, we know that the power of their prayer and their meditation is much stronger, or can be much stronger and more powerful than actions. So every one of us choose the way of behaving when difficult things happen in our close surroundings or in our region of the world, when it more touches us. We know that there are conflicts and wars in the world all the time, but when it's close to us and we are bombarded by the media, we have actually two choices. One is to just sink in and receive all these difficult media images, videos, and talks about what is happening, which is very difficult for those of us who care. And the other choice is to retune ourselves, as we said, like a guitar or any musical instrument. When we detect, when we diagnose in ourselves that we sink in our energies, in our vibrations, that we are dispirited by what is happening, our responsibility is to take a deep breath, to reattune ourselves as a perfect tuned instrument, and then to fill ourselves with light and love, non-violence, and to spread that light and love and non-violence and peace. This is our responsibility, and just these were a few words to remind ourselves that this program is very beautiful, very enlightening. It is not just theoretical, it is a tool for our personal transformation, And thanks to this personal transformation, we can help raise the vibrations of all and send light and love and peace and nonviolence to all the world, and especially to the parts and to the people in the world that need it most today. Thank you.
Thank you, dear Brigitte. Now, going back to our program, dear friends, in our previous session, we have seen the beautiful presentation and workshop of our dears Elena and Varsha on universal prayers and quotations. As we know, Satyasai education is experiential and transformational. So today's focus will be on group activities.
It is good, before we start with the presentation, to pray together with this, as we said, with this prayer, this universal prayer, Samasta Loka Sukhino Bhavantu, as it is, we have prepared it. So we'll take 5 minutes before we start the session to watch this beautiful video and to unite our prayers and the light and love from our hearts. And then we go on with the program.
Thank you.
Hello again. I would like to kindly call again Suzanne Palermo to present to us group activities. Good morning, Suzanne.
Good morning, dear Vassiliki.
I would like to give you now a few words for Suzanne. Suzanne Palermo was born in the United States of America and moved to Italy at the age of 12. She completed her studies at the Academy of Fine Arts of Rome and later moved to Milan, where she worked in the editorial field for children as illustrator and project designer on a freelance basis. Since 1996, she lives in the Italian canton Ticino of Switzerland. Suzanne first heard about Satyasai education in human values in 1989. And since then, the very beginning, she adopted the program in her professional work and as a life compass. She has been endeavoring ever since to develop value-oriented material for children, stories, songs, activities, and material support for teachers, parents, and all those who are willing to foster in their students and families a human values education and a deeper perspective into life's marvels and mysteries. She is the author of the book, The Story of Marty, A Journey on Planet Earth. She has developed didactical material rotating around this ongoing project and launched a website container to share part of this material in 2013. Additionally, she has published a variety of articles and worksheets dedicating to human values, both online and through a local Swiss magazine since 2018. Suzanne has been collaborating for many years with the ISSE South Europe and is currently its vice president. Over the years, she has contributed to the development of the Educare magazines and the Institute's handbook. Since 2019, she has participated in many seminars in South Europe as a speaker. Since she collaborates with the Swiss Peace Forum in Lugano, offering workshops to students from elementary to high school age, and is the co-founder of the open space Arte e Valori, which is an initiative carried out with her husband and is situated in Giubiasco. The space organizes free exhibitions, cultural meetings, and human values workshops for children, to which all are welcome, from art lovers to children, with special attention to the elderly and people with disabilities. Dear participants, just a reminder to keep your microphones and cameras off during the presentation, which will then be followed by a questions and answers session. Dear Suzanne,
Thank you, dear Vassiliki. So thank you again, dear Vassiliki, for this very warm introduction and presentation. And thank you, dear George and Brigitte, for also your loving words of introduction to today's session. I have a lot of things to share with you today. I'm very happy to talk about this topic of group activities, which we will also see as very relevant to the situation we are living today. And I'd like to immediately begin by explaining why I chose the image that you see as an introductory image to this presentation. Of course, it belongs to a group activity. It belongs to a special project that we will see shortly. But I feel that this image exemplifies the meaning of group activity. We see these characters, children, human beings, they are walking together. They are moving together. They are growing together. And they are learning to live together. And how is it that they are doing this? They are representing, they are practicing human values. And we will see more about this shortly. Now I'd like to, sorry, this is not working. Okay, sorry, this is technology. So I'd like to have an overview with you again on this frame, the way that we have framed. We've been working with this slide that frames the five teaching techniques. And we have, as you know, we have been already through silent sitting, meditation on the light, storytelling, universal prayers, and quotations. And since the very beginning, Laruccia pointed out very, very nicely how, of course, each of these techniques can be used on its own. However, it is when we use them together that the magic comes out, that we see how they really facilitate the children's absorption, how they are able, the children, thanks to these techniques, can assimilate the meaning of the values and, of course, of the process of the group activity. And we have seen how each technique, though, of course, all the values are involved in these techniques, they are somehow connected to one of the five human values. And this also means that when we use the five techniques together, we are actually working with all of the five values together. And each technique also has some particular special connection with one level of our understanding, of our learning, of our personality. So using them together really helps the children in their all-round educational process. And today, as you see, group activities is connected to nonviolence. As we have just seen the characters walking together and learning to live together, participating in this case in group activities together, they learn to interact and to foster peaceful coexistence and right human relations. And we know that this builds harmony and unity, and that the outcome of harmony and unity is nonviolence. So I'd like to take a step back just a moment and reconnect to the four pillars of education that we have seen already when Marianne presented the pedagogy and philosophy of Satyasaya Educare. Now, these four pillars are exceptional because they have been identified by the International Commission of Education for the 21st century in 1996, the Delors Commission, they've been identified to see exactly what we need to make education complete and integral. So we have seen that these four pillars are learning to know, the acquisition of knowledge, learning to do, the acquisition of skills, learning to live together, the process that involves our learning to interact and live well together, live in peace together and in harmony, and learning to be, which is the process that implies self-inquiry, self-understanding, self-development, and self-knowledge. Now, what happens? Of course, you have seen already that our third pillar, learning to live together, corresponds to today's technique, to group activity. However, if we think about it, when we do work together, interact together, pursue a goal together, what do? We share our knowledge, our perspective, and our understanding. We share our skills, our know-how, and we learn a lot about ourselves when we work with others. So what does this mean? It means that group activity is in itself a complete process of education. Now, I chose this wonderful quote by Mother Teresa that is so simple, and we know simplicity is winning. It is so effective. I can do things you cannot. You can do things I cannot. Together, we can do great things. So, of course, group activity means bringing our resources together, sharing our understanding and our skills and our perspective. And it also fosters a spirit of humility, because I may be very good at doing a few things or even many things, but I may not know how to do what you do. So we learn by being together to open up to everyone's resources and potential and build something together. Now, if we look at our four pillars, we can actually also see how they correspond to the values of truth, right action, peace, and love. Because when we uplift our process of acquisition of knowledge with higher perspective, with human values, this process turns into our quest for truth. And when we uplift the process of acquisition of skills, building our skills with higher human values perspective, this process, our skills reach a point of excellence and perfection and turn into right action. And when we uplift this process of learning to live together, we know that we can achieve a state of peace. And when we deepen our self-understanding and we go deeper into our true human nature, we realize that there's a core, an inner core, in essence, that is love, and that is equal in all beings. And we also know, and the founder of this program has stressed this many times, that when we practice truth, right action, peace, and love, when these values manifest in our lives, what is the outcome, the end result? It is non-violence. So before we continue and look at some examples that I brought today to share with you, I just wanted to spend 1 minute on what counts most. We have said this already, but we will never end stressing how important this point is. And I will talk about this through a story. It's a story of a teacher in Thailand. His name is Dr. Judo. And he told us this story. He said that one day he was teaching his class of students. And you know, in Asian countries, in Thailand, they have the habit, the cultural tradition and of taking their shoes off before they enter into any closed building. So of course, Dr. Judo was barefoot. And at a certain point, his rubber or his eraser, if we want to use American English, fell on the floor. So what did he do? He did exactly what this little boy or little girl is doing in our picture. He very casually picked it up with his foot. He brought it back up to the blackboard and he used it. At the end of the lesson, a little boy ran up to Dr. Judo. And he was so excited. He was thrilled. He had a grin from here to here. And he said, "Dr. Judo, I'm so happy. Today I really, really, really learned something." So Dr. Judo bent over. He was also a little bit flattered. He said, "Well, tell me what I taught you. Tell me, what did you learn today?" And the little boy looked at him smiling and he said, "Well, I learned to pick up an eraser with my foot." So this beautiful story reminds us, and I will never forget it, it really reminds us that what impacts the children is not only what we teach, but it is that which we are. And it is our example that really teaches the children. It is our example that really transfers a lot of messages to them, and we know this. So even when it comes to group activity, we need to remind ourselves about this and remember that the children will learn about interacting with others, about socializing with others by observing us. They will observe how we interact with with the co-teachers, with their parents, with the class of children themselves. They will learn from us to speak kindly, to be attentive and listen to them. They will learn all this through us. So of course, it is very important, as the founder of the program has said many times, to remember that teachers and parents, of course, are reservoirs from which, through the process of education, students draw the water of life. So the values come alive, living them. This is a beautiful picture of the children in Serbia who are playing a value hopscotch. The SSE-SE institutes around the world have identified throughout the years a set of group activities, which are value quizzes, group discussion, role play and drama, value games, art and craft work, outdoor activity and sports, and of course, various special projects, including community service projects, environmental awareness projects. Naturally, all of these confer many social skills and many self skills to the children. And what is most important to remember, and we know this too, is that children learn by doing. We can be reminded about this with these wonderful words that I'm sure you know. I hear and I forget. I see and I remember. I do and I understand. So there are even statistics that have proved this, that children learn mostly by doing. So of course, group activity is the pinnacle of experiential learning. So when it comes to talking about group activity within the context of SSE-SE Educare, of course we mean fun with a purpose. And all the activities need to be fun. They need to be entertaining and amusing. They need to interest the children, especially when it comes to older children. We really need to offer them an activity that can involve them and interest them. And the activity needs to have a moment of reflection, during which the children or the group ponders and reflects deeply over the process. They go deeper into the process of the activity, and of course, deeper into the meaning of the value that the activity would like to enhance. And this fusion of fun and reflection, of course, brings about a transformation in the children. It builds their awareness. And every activity that we choose to use is always raised thanks to the value perspective. There is always an objective, a goal that is based on a value, that is focusing on a value. Of course, group activities within the context of SSE Educare stresses two things also. We hope and we wish and we aim at helping the children learn to live together, learn to live in peace and in harmony. And this means that we foster in every way possible cooperation versus competition. And of course, give a lot of attention to nonviolent communication skills, both verbal and nonverbal. And this is when the teacher comes into play, because of course, through a group activity, the teacher or a parent at home with a group of children, they are able to observe the children. They see how the children behave and interact and speak to each other. So they can really grasp those attitudes that need to be corrected, transformed, and sit near the children who need maybe a little bit more assistance in this and help the overall group become more aware of the importance of selecting the right words, being kind and caring with each other. Now they learn, of course, through group activity, a variety of human values. These are just a few: listening skills, respect, kindness, trust, flexibility, responsibility, sharing, concentration, commitment, team spirit, unity, and unity and diversity, of course. And we know that the values that children learn are the values that they live. So this is something that reminds us that we need to also create an environment of love. We need to, especially when it comes to the moments in which we reflect with the children, we go deeper, that is a special moment of the overall group activity. So we need to create this magic and create an environment that will be conducive and help the children really feel the harmony and peace that will help them go within and share their deeper feelings. Because the values they learn are the values they live, but the values they live are the values they learn. So we need to prepare the right environment so they will live the values. So the key difference. Now, naturally, we include always a value perspective in the group activities. And we can, of course, start out, we can use a lot of traditional games and activities. However, we can uplift the activities with this human value perspective. This is an example that I brought because we actually used it here in the open space with children. This is the traditional game of pin the tail on the donkey, which I'm sure you all know. All you would need to do, disorient the children. They are blindfolded and they have to find their orientation, their direction, and find and pin the tail closest possible to where it needs to be put on the donkey. But here it became pin the heart on the sun. So we used the same identical traditional game, but we added something more to it. And the children carried out the game. They had a lot of fun, but this pin the heart on the sun was, of course, an opportunity to sit down with them, have a group discussion, remind them and talk about the importance of going within, of connecting to our heart, which is a place of beauty and sunshine, and to really ask our heart for guidance, for direction when we need to make some important decision, and actually always. So the key difference is that a value is always interwoven and brought to life through the experience of group activity. And of course, abstract concepts and values sometimes for the children become tangible because, as we said, the activity is experiential. They live the values as they are carrying out the activity. And the activities are always geared to take them deeper, to enhance an inner inquiry. So let's begin going one by one. I will not have time to go through these slides too much in depth, but I would like to share them all with you. So of course, we have quizzes and group discussion as an option for group activity. We can ask the children or the group to define the values or to define what the values are not. We can ask them to explain a quote so they go deeper into the meaning of the quote, or to create a poem or a group poem or their own poem that they then share with one another. And I included the Fantastic Three because I love this tool. It's a teaching tool that I learned from an Italian writer and teacher who wrote a beautiful book called Grammar of Fantasy, in which he gave many hints for teachers. And this is a hint, it's a tool he suggests to use to motivate children to write, to help them develop good writing skills. And actually his tool is the Fantastic Tool. Just all we need to do is ask the children to select two things that have nothing to do with one another, with each other. Let's say a giraffe and a typewriter. Of course, immediately the children want to write about it. They want to talk about it. They want to create a story about these two things, about a giraffe and a typewriter that apparently have nothing to do with each other. So why are they together in this story? And of course, we can add a value. So the giraffe and the typewriter have something to do with patience. We can tell a story about this. And I am using a picture from Italy just to stress, of course, that group activity implies it can be targeted to all age groups. These are teenagers that worked, they carried out a group activity and pinpointed a series of crossword, value crosswords that they actually took and shared to a retiring home with the elderly. So it shows that a group activity can also ripen and become a service project. Then, of course, we have role play and dramas. This beautiful picture illustrates the Animal Concert, which is a beautiful play on unity and diversity that focuses on unity and diversity that the Italian Institute of SSE Education shared in a local school during a three-day meeting that was organized by an association called Vivi Pet that is dedicated to sensitize people to build awareness towards vivisection, of course, against vivisection. And the story is beautiful. I'd love to tell you the whole story, but it's about five animals from five different continents with five different traditional musical instruments that learn to play together. And the harmony that they make is so beautiful and perfect that it awakens the queen of nature, who is this young girl standing, because she hasn't heard such a melody, such a divine melody for so many years. And of course, she blesses butterflies and flowers and the animals, and then she goes back to sleep. And I added the focus word also communication, because of course a drama, or even when children write, it's always a good opportunity to also stress, to help them understand that if they want to convey something, we need to really go deeper and understand what is the message we would like to convey, so we can then find the right words to do so. And if in the case of a drama, we need to really bring out the essence of the message of this drama, how can we do so? So let's select the right words and act in the right way. Of course, we have a variety of value games. As Vassiliki was saying, I developed over the years quite a few games related to this project, the project of Marty, who falls from a rainbow onto planet Earth. And Marty says, living in the world is precious and rare. I don't want to sit and stare. I'll look and see, taste and touch, think and feel, and find out what is true and real. And this little poem somehow also emphasizes that group activities always involve all of the five senses of the children. But as it says, Marty wants to find out what is true and real. Every game, every activity, as I've already said, wants to take them deeper into themselves also. So here's a little girl playing Marty. She's part of a group. And as said, there would be more to say, but let's go on. Of course, there are various activities connected to value topics. In the case of Marty, these are a few of them. I won't go into this slide. I just like to stress how these games are also meant to be made with the children. So you do not buy them in a shop and play the game. You actually make them with the children. And this is part of the process. It is part of the group activity. And then you play the game. And you can see the character memory where children match heart, head, and hand. And here is a picture with a dear friend of mine who is also a participant of this meeting. So I'd like to say hello, Pinuccia. And we dedicated three afternoons to the children and to the topic of music. And we began by talking about its silence. Here we have the children in Serbia again who are playing hopscotch. When the music stops, wherever they are standing, It can be either a value, a human value, or a negative human trait. They need to use their discrimination, understand what the word means, and if it's a negative human trait, step out of the game. Then we have this little book of rules that the children have made. Again, this was an opportunity to sit down with them, talk about the rules, bring the rules out from within them, because really they know them all. And then we brought it all together. I made these little drawings, and the following week, the children colored the little booklet and took it home. So another very happy activity. And again, just to stress the point that there is always a moment of fun and entertainment, but contained within the activity, which is meant to take the children towards a deep reflection, towards an inner transformation. Then we have another game, which is guess the values with rhythm. You can use it with or without rhythm. In this case, there are a series of cards. They are this big, and the children do not see what the cards are, the illustration, until for some reason they pick it, and then they are invited to explain the story, tell the story that they see, and eventually define the values also that they see. And then there is a group discussion, group sharing, and this has also proved a very fun and very effective group activity. And this is another idea. It's a board game with 100 game cards. And as I said, all our activities always have a focus, a value focus, an objective. In this case, it is to help children become self-conscious and build a good character. So this again can be made with the children and then played together. By the way, I played it with a group of adults and we had a lot of fun. So there are, as I said, 100 game cards with many questions, many daily contexts. Like, for example, last night your mother asked you to clear off the table and you were very happy to help her. You deserve a star. Or is there another human value that this makes you think of? Well, maybe the little girl or boy could say obedience. Then you deserve a diamond. It has a lot of levels, this board game. And we can certainly share it with all of you. Now, I included storytelling in this presentation, though storytelling, we have seen a beautiful presentation with Veritza and Esma, and we know that it is a technique of its own. However, stories are an enormous source of group activity, as Veritza also pointed out. So it is just to remember how a story can connect us, link us to a variety of activities so we can deepen the understanding of the children and go uplift their understanding also of their perspective with regard to the value. And storytelling, we know, puts values in context. Here is a group also of children in Greece. They are enacting a story, the story of the life of Mother Teresa. Art, crafts, and creativity. I chose the keyword inner vision because there is nothing like arts that takes us within. And when we go within with arts, then we bring out. And it builds unity of head, heart, and hand. I use this picture. It's a little girl downstairs who is touching one of the paintings that were on exhibit. We have quite a few times classes of children who come to visit the exhibits. And of course, you know, you can never touch the paintings in an exhibit, but at a certain point, this was a very special kind of painting, as you see. It's really telling you, touch me, touch me. And so I told the children, if you line up properly at the end before you leave, I will allow you to touch one of the paintings. And they did, of course. But I'm also using this picture to just stress how important it is also when talking about group activity, to take the children to museums, to take them to see art exhibitions, to take them to concerts, to take them to plays, to dramas, so that they are exposed to creativity, to the arts, to culture, and so they can cultivate a sense of beauty in their lives. Now, arts and crafts, we know, confer a lot of skills and bring forth a lot of human values. They coordinate head, heart, and hand and develop motor skills and promote choice making, self-confidence, imagination, self-expression, creativity, commitment, concentration, among other things. And of course, as we said, this connection with one's deeper being. Here's a little boy downstairs. He's making his own artwork. That day we had that, during that period, we had an art exhibition, which is more graphic. This is the artist, and the four children came to visit the exhibition and then stayed for a few hours in the afternoon to make out their own artwork. Then we have sports and outdoor activity. And of course, this resonates with life is a game, play it. And we know how outdoor activity is so important with children. Not only it gives them free play for their bundle of energy, they are a bundle of energy. And of course, it keeps them physically fit. So it is something that we need, that everyone needs actually to be physically fit and in health. And we know that when we play a sport, so we are in a team, perhaps we can cultivate the spirit of team player. I added the 5 D's here because we have seen them already. And if you are in any sport or many outdoor activities, you need to follow the 5 D's. They are very important skills to always have in your pocket. Discipline, dedication, determination, discrimination, and a sense of duty. So we reach our special projects. We are back to one of the characters of the beginning that we have seen at the beginning of this presentation. I have chosen a keyword commitment because a special project can be longer than a normal group activity. And so it calls for commitment. And sharing is caring. If we reconnect to the teenagers from Italy, a special project can turn into a service project that we share with others. This project in particular is Project Star. This is an ongoing project and it is a virtual walk for peace. The children receive this empty character that you see on the slide and are invited to personalize it. And mostly, of course, this is an opportunity to talk about peace, to talk about the importance of practicing, of sharing human values, of building right human relations and peaceful coexistence. And so the children are also and mostly invited to choose one value that they feel is essential to create peace. And so their characters all bear on their t-shirt, on their sweater, on the sign that they may be carrying, the value that they chose. Some of them you can see here are kindness, let's be always together, sharing, peace, love, and happiness, friendship, obedience, and again, peace. So this is a beautiful project. I have to say that we invited also adults to participate in it, and they did it gladly. So, and we managed to prepare 120 of these little characters that we put up all over the open space and hope to use it again soon. Of course, the preparation of a human values exhibition is a special project. It's a huge group activity and a great group activity. This is an exhibition again carried out by the Italian Institute of Sacchetti. Again, for the meeting that was organized by ViviPet, they prepared many, as you can see, beautiful posters. Of course, this involved selecting the quotes, selecting stories, illustrating the images and preparing the posters and even setting it up in the gym. So it's an enormous group activity that really called for the resources of everyone. Then we have, of course, outings that can be dedicated to eco-education, to environmental awareness, and or to a science project, for example, or to cleaning up. In case you are interested, on our website, we have these eco-education worksheets that you can download that always provide just a small focus and some additional text with a hint or an idea that could be carried out as a group activity. And I could not talk about group activities without mentioning magazines, the development of magazines, as this comes also from my profession. It is such a wonderful activity, and it is so complete and really brings everyone together. And mostly it is something that brings out a final product. And this final product belongs to no one. It belongs to everyone. Actually, it doesn't even belong to the group that prepared the magazine. It belongs to the people that the magazine is meant for. So it's a beautiful activity. This is a magazine that we had carried out in Italy years ago with a group of seven children. As you see, you may notice they also had enacted the play, The Animal Concert. The children each wrote a story. We helped them really reflect on the inner meaning that they wanted to convey through the story. And then they went out on the road and they interviewed all the passerbys, asking them, what is happiness for you? And they made an interview. And so the magazine also contains a beautiful interview on the meaning of happiness. So we have reached the end. This last slide is dedicated to group singing, though of course it is a technique of its own. We know that group singing kindles and develops harmony and love and group unity. I chose this beautiful picture from Greece because for me it is very musical. But of course we will be talking about this technique in our next session. So thank you so much for your attention. It's been a great pleasure for me to be with you today.
Thank you, dear Suzanne. You have inspired us all with your rich and colorful presentation. Dear friends, now is 11 o'clock. We will have a break for 5 minutes. And we will come back for the beautiful interactive workshop of our dear Fabiana, which will start at 11:05 Central European time. Dear friends, we are back. I hope you enjoyed your short break. And now I will invite dear Fabiana to continue with her interactive workshop on group activities. Good morning, dear Fabiana.
Good morning, dear Vassiliki.
I would like to give you a few words for Fabiana. Fabiana Laruccia was born in Taranto, Italy. She is a member of the Institute of SSE Education of South Europe. She is a trainer and a referent for ISSE Italy. Fabiana holds a degree in economics at the University of Alma Mater Studiorum of Bologna. She continued her studies, obtaining a master's degree in organizational communication. Fabiana deepened her studies on sustainability issues and economy for the common good. She wanted this to be implemented in businesses and schools and oriented toward the promotion of an ethical social model that focuses on the well-being of people and the planet. She further obtained a specialization in humanistic counseling to facilitate the improvement of human relationships and group communication. Fabiana currently carries out consultancy and training activities in companies and schools to implement sustainability processes to communicate the contribution to the common good and promote ethical communication and life skills. Her intent is to inspire and facilitate the awakening of human values for the evolution of an ethical consciousness and the qualitative change of our life on the planet. Fabiana, please, the ground is yours.
Thank you, Vassiliki, for your nice introduction. I'm very happy to be with you again to facilitate the workshop. Now, I share the screen. Today, the workshop is on harmony in group activities. The purpose of this workshop is to reflect together and identify the human qualities and the social skills that facilitate harmony and good group activity. What human qualities are important to collaborate, cooperate, make decisions, find solutions? I would like to put a specific focus on observing how individual harmony is reflected in group harmony. During the course, we had the opportunity to understand how individual harmony is expressed in the unity of head, heart, hands, and how, consequently, it favors a coherence between thoughts, words, and actions. When a person brings this inner harmony into a group, it is easier for hearts to connect, tune in, resonate together, and to create a single heart. A continuous process is activated. The group creates a context in which self-confidence and a greater inner harmony can develop, which in turn will be reflected even more in the group. The group, working together, tunes in more and more and expresses a group conscience, a unique and a special harmony, like a music with its particular notes. I find very beautiful to consider the symphony as a metaphor for a wonderful cooperation. The etymology of the word symphony comes from the Greek symphonia, harmony, concord of sounds, from sin together, and phone, sound. Now we are going to listen to this famous canon in D major by Pachelbel for a few minutes. We can observe with special attention the way in which the various instruments dialogue and cooperate.
Thank you.
Αφήνω μέσα, πάτε μην τελείωσουν. Θα έρθω, μόλις τελείωσε θα έρθω μέσα.
Who listened to this beautiful musical composition, a metaphor to highlight how the people who play the individual instruments listen to each other, communicate, relate, and create group harmony. Let's reflect for a moment. What are human qualities and social skills that the various members of the group express and that favor a good cooperation and a good group activity? We will do this reflection by drawing a flower of harmony following three steps. The first step is to reflect individually and drawing a personal flower of qualities. The second step is to share reflections in the small group and to create a group flower. The first step is to combine flowers and to realize a community garden. Let's start with the first step. The first step is to reflect individually and draw a flower. Please take a pen and a piece of paper and draw your own flower. You can write within the flower's petals the human qualities and the social skills that you think facilitate group activities. The time of 3 minutes of music will mark the time of reflection.
Thank you.
Now we have the second step with the group session. In this second step, we are going to share the individual reflections and draw a group flower. Instruction for group activity. The group appoints a facilitator who will report to the plenary. The group shares the individual reflections and draw a group flowers with several petals which describe the human qualities or social skills important for a good group activity. The group also shares some obstacles that can reduce harmony in group activity. How to overcome them? The facilitators will communicate in plenary 5 human qualities or social skills shared in the group. After, we will create a community garden. Now we will put the instruction in the chat and we can begin session group. We have joined the flowers group and we have created a community garden. Now I share the screen now. And I have made a list of some important qualities and social skills, as you also have said. I will also write the qualities shared today together. And some of the human qualities, social skills necessary for a good group activity, as active listening, empathy, respect, kindness, joy, self-control, patience, trust, authenticity, loyalty, sincerity, discernment, calm, appreciation, gratitude, enthusiasm, solidarity. And then I would like to conclude with this quote from Assagioli. What is the bridge between the individual and the universal? It is the group. We can attain a group consciousness. We can at first unify ourselves with another individual at love's highest level. We can then join a small group and then a larger group, larger and larger, and then gradually move into more extensive groups until we reach a certain degree of universal awareness. E Satya Sai tell us that the journey is from I to we to he. Thank you all for these beautiful reflections made together.
Thank you, dear Fabiana, for this wonderful workshop. And also thank you to Suzanne for her more than wonderful presentation. Dear Suzanne, would you like to share with us a few words?
Thank you, dear Vassiliki, and thank you, Fabiana. I really enjoyed your workshop. And I'm happy that now we have this beautiful community garden that is flourishing and full of fragrance. What I'd mainly like to say is that let's remember that our real group activity is our life. Our life itself is our group activity, our living together. So let's just continue sowing the seeds of human values, practicing them, understanding them, and to make these gardens more and more filled with flowers and colors. And let's continue to unify in with the energy of love, pure love. So thank you all so much again.
Thank you, Suzanne. Fabiana, Would you like to add anything as well?
I'm very happy for this beautiful sharing, because the love is the human value that unify all presence.
Thank you, Fabiana. Thank you all, dear friends, for your attention and your participation. And we will be in touch again for the next session, number 12, on group singing on March 26. If you have any questions, please write to us on the Institute email. Now, we will listen again to the song and pray together, may all the worlds be happy.
Summer.